Another thing that you can do is descriptively set the scene to make readers feel emotion. Even if nothing is really going on, you can use descriptive imagery to make readers feel something. So let's go back to that example of Suzanne. She is arriving at a church. However, something that I can do is tell you how her walk was from her car to the front door of the church. So here is a bad example of that. She walked out of the front door of her car to the front door of the church. Like I said, that's a bad example. So instead of that, you can use something like this. For a moment, Suzanne meticulously searched through the tiny spaced area until she found a secluded spot in the back of the parking lot. As she exited from her gray 2002 Toyota Corolla, she quickly gazed up at the sky, which was the same color as her car. She felt a slight sprinkle of rain on her left cheek, which blemished her perfect makeup, instantly making her feel very subconscious about her appearance. She would have only felt it would have been appropriate for the storm to begin and drown her in the rain, just like the pressure of being at that church was drowning her soul. This is similar to the example from before, but it is another equally great way of creating the tension that is needed to hook your audience. Even if there isn't a hint of action taking place for the first few moments of your story, you can create the action by creatively and descriptively describing the setting and the feelings of the characters involved in the scene. So that is it for how you hook people in the beginning. But the next question is, how do you keep them hooked throughout your chapter? To know this and more, meet me in the next chapter where we will go over the middle of your chapter.